Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Yes, I know I'm a little late to this one, but I was sleeping all morning. I saw it on the Discord server, posted both in the changelog and people were talking about it, and I was really excited to actually get up and talk about this thing. The SM.79... Oh, you fucking idiot. The SM.92, which is the second of the two very strange, unique-looking aircraft on the Italian tech tree. At least I believe that this would be coming for the Italian tech tree. I don't know where else we'd be going. The SM-79 being the first one that we got in the game not too long ago. If you remember correctly, or if I remember correctly, on my wishlist video, or one of my wishlist videos, I had both the SM-91 and the SM-92 for Italian's attacker-slash-heavy fighter tree, and both of these are now in the game, so that's really, really relieving because I think these aircraft are really interesting. While I have never flown the SM-91, I look forward to at least owning it, even though I've heard not so great things about it. And the same goes for the SM-92, which you can see right here, which is going to hopefully help add a little bit of variety to Italy's ground attack capabilities, maybe do a slightly better job than that of the SM-91. So the SM-92 is a late-war Italian prototype heavy fighter developed from the SM-91 that preceded it. Although this twin bird never got to the front lines, Italian pilots will have the chance to thoroughly evaluate its design under combat conditions after its introduction in War Thunder with update 1.87 that is upcoming. Briefly, it is a lightened and further development version of the Italian SM-91 prototype heavy fighter, featuring more versatile weaponry. Here we've got some history on the unit. So this one, unlike the SM-91, looks vastly more German, and I don't just mean that in the fact that it has the insignia, I mean that literally in the sense that it looks a lot more German. The nose, the cockpit, everything about it just looks more German to me. Maybe that's just me, I don't know. But you can see this thing's just clamored with bombs, it's got three cannons, I believe, and machine guns, so I guess we'll have to find out here, hold on. It's also got a very cute butt cannon, which I think is just nifty-pifty. Okay, so moving along. In War Thunder, the SM-92 will join the heavy fighter line at rank 4 of the Italian aviation tree, with the release of upcoming update 1.87. Unlike its predecessor, the SM-92 is slightly faster and more agile due to the weight reductions, and also offers more varied armament compared to the unified cannon armament of the SM-91. The greatest difference between the SM-91 and the new SM-92 concerned flight performance. Although still a twin-engine heavy fighter, the SM-92 had its weight reduced by several hundred kilograms as a result of the removal of the center-mounted cockpit and its subsequent integration into the left fuselage. Due to this, the aircraft's top speed has to be slightly increased, going up to 615 kilometers an hour at medium altitudes, while overall maneuverability and climb rate also see some improvement. Further differences between the SM-92 and preceding SM-91 can be found in its armament. Unlike the plane-shredding complement of its six 20mm cannons featured on the SM-91, the SM-92 offers its pilots more guns at the expense of gun caliber. In other words, the SM-92 is fitted with just three 20mm cannons, and I think they're MG-151s, they better be, and an additional four 12.7mm Beretta SAFAT heavy machine guns. Also worth noting is the fact that all of this firepower is spread across the aircraft's two fuselage sections, specifically the noses and the center wing, making deflection shots slightly more tricky to pull off at times, due to the relatively large separation between the guns. Oh, goody. Oh well, I don't really care. There's a nice side shot of the aircraft. I think it's a nice looking aircraft, honestly. Yeah, it looks weird, but I think it's a nice looking one for a twin-based aircraft, at least. I don't like the idea of only having one cockpit. I've never liked that. I liked how, you know, like the twin Mustang handles it and stuff, where they actually have both cockpits, but only one of them is piloted, you know, something like those, and then the other one's like the navigator or whatever. That kind of thing I like. But this messes with me. This messes with my... It needs to be symmetrical. You done fucked it up. And here we've got a nice shot of the front end, so you can see two of the cannons there. Or those might be machine guns, actually. I don't know where the cannons are. I would imagine that two of the cannons would be in the nose caps. But then again, if it has... These could be machine gun... I don't know where the hell the guns are. Where it says three and four machine guns, so perhaps... But I don't see anywhere for, like, three cannons. I'd say one, and then where's the other one? Because the four machine guns could, you know, those... Okay, whatever. Maybe we'll have a... Is it... There's nothing in the wings, is there? Not that I can see. Unless you count that as one of the 20mm cannons. That would be kind of a letdown, but... I don't know. Okay. In addition to blazing forward-facing weaponry... Oh, no, here we go. Yeah, the rear hemisphere of the aircraft is closely guarded by a single remote-controlled heavy machine gun turret, integrated into the aircraft's vertical stabilizer. And if all of this firepower is still not enough for some pilots, then those will be glad to hear that the SM-92 also inherits all of the secondary ordnance options of its predecessor as well. We thank these people here that allowed this to basically happen in the game with their information in the archives and such. So credit goes to them. The SM-92 will join the ranks of the... I don't know. I don't want to fuck it up. I don't want to piss any Italians off. With the release of upcoming update 1.87, rather. In the meantime, however, be sure to keep a watchful eye on the news for more information on the next major update coming to the game very soon. Until then, clear skies, pilots. So yeah, guys, I'm actually really excited about this, seeing another new Italian aircraft come to the game. It's nice. I hope we get some more RE-2000s. Gotta be honest, because I really like to see some more of those. I want to see some of the more beefy versions of their aircraft. There's also that was on my wish list. There's also that Italian mono-wing dive bomber, which I think would be a nice addition to the low ranks. But I don't know, maybe not. There's also that biplane. Whatever. Anyways, if you have missed any of the other development blogs on update 1.87, there's a handful of really nice things coming, including the British Challenger 2, which will be the first rank 7 ground vehicle for British ground forces. The British are also receiving the Seahawk FGA-6 rank 5 attacker aircraft. There's an event going right now, the Sea Voyage event, that you can take part in and or buy the tasks from. Both of these vehicles are collectible. The rewards are the United States rank 2 flying boat premium PBM-3 Mariner and the rank 3 premium Leningrad destroyer for the Soviet Union. A new map is coming, Alaska. It'll be the first map with skyscrapers in it for combined battles. The USS Summers is coming for the latest destroyer on the United States Naval Forces tech tree. The Germans are receiving the MiG-19S as their first rank 6 jet aircraft. The United States are also receiving the USS Brooklyn light cruiser, which is a crazy, devastatingly good-looking light cruiser. And then lastly, the Soviets are receiving the T-80U as their first new rank 7 ground forces vehicle. So, yay. Anyways, happy, or looking for... I don't know what the fuck I was trying to say. Looking forward to seeing what else they have coming for update 1.87. Still a handful of things that I'm really hoping for. There was also something that you guys might not have noticed. Not that many people are going to see this, but if we hop on over... Hold on a minute. We hop on over here to something that you guys might not have seen. There is a video that was released on the Twitter, on the Japanese Twitter, rather, War Thunder Japan. And it shows a little tease of what is clearly the ass end of a Type 74. So chances are we have the Type 74G Kai coming in this update, probably as a rank 5 premium, so the Japanese finally get their rank 5 MBT premium. If you are excited for that, then you might want to prepare your wallets. I finally was able to have the opportunity to buy one of the packs that I've been wanting for quite some time, but after seeing this teaser, I am now holding on to that money in case the Type 74 G-Kai is a, which it most likely will be, by the way, a premium pack, and if it is, I'm going to end up getting that instead. So keep an eye out for that if you're excited for a new rank 5 premium for Japan. It's about damn time they get a proper one, and the Type 74 G-Kai has only been suggested and requested for about as long as the Japanese ground forces have been talked about. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.